When I recently salvaged lots of vintage computer parts, I got my hands on this Diagnostics debug card, which seemed to be intended to be connected via the parallel printer port. The question is, will this really work the way I believe it should? Retrocomputing is the use of older computer hardware and software in modern times. I'm the vintage collector, and these are my stories. I'm well aware about ISA and PCI diagnostics card, but I've never seen anyone like this. What makes it special is the parallel socket, so it's clearly intended to be plugged into the printer port. Along with the board and a cable came a CD and a small instruction manual, which contains little to no explanations but many pages of actual BIOS error codes. Plus, the manual is about an LPT and mini PCI combo card, the PT088, while the one I have is the PT086A, a pure parallel port only card. With this little information at hand, I set out to do some online research about this obscure diagnostics card. The original website pctesttool.com has long gone, but thanks to the Internet Archive, I could still get a glimpse at the webpage. But there was not much to see. The page didn't reveal any specific information, and the download links leading to further documentation were all broken. But fear not, I had a CD included, which is supposed to contain documentation. The CD was clearly made by the German distributor, and not the original vendor. Plus, it obviously was thought to be only applicable to Windows users, so no way to access the data from a Mac. I had to access it from a Windows PC in order to have this flash-based autoplay menu appear. This would then point me at the documentation, though again, it was the same as the printed copy I had and totally not matching up my particular diagnostics card. What's very obscure to me is the link on the bottom left, reading Urlaubstipps, like recommended holiday destinations. I wonder why someone would place such a link onto the documentation CD for a PC diagnostics card. At least I would get hold of the URL of the German distributor, so I could also have a glimpse at it via the Internet Archive. Also to note here, the page seems to have existed only for some time between 2008 and 2012, when it started to disappear. Funny is how they advertise full SMD-Bestückung, which means every component is a surface mount device. Well, some sarcasm here, it's like someone is selling you a car, promoting it with the fact that it actually has a steering wheel. Also interesting how they put these holiday ads here again. Besides the fact this page is ugly as hell, it literally screams unprofessional, even by late 2000 standards. But at least I could get access to the actual product page of my diagnostics card, though again, only with dead download links and not really useful information. As it looks right now, I will just need to try it out and see what happens. So I have here this 386 machine, which will expose a disk controller failure at startup. I have added a standard ISA diagnostics card to catch the BIOS error codes, in this case codes 90 and 91 for the floppy and hard disk controller. Now I'm wiring up the LPT diagnostics card, though I realized that I had the wrong gender cable, so I needed to get another one. For my second attempt, I use a parallel cable from the iOmega SIP drive, which happens to have the correct gender on both ends. Plus, I have to provide some USB power, as the card won't be powered from the parallel port itself. Though here as well, I observe something wrong. I would expect it to light up already. Nope. A check with the multimeter reveals that I'm only getting some 2.85 volts as opposed to the standard 5 volts. I guess I'm a victim to a faulty power supply. My USB cable is actually too short to reach to the stationary power supply, so I had to shift everything around. Also, to exclude any potential issues with the parallel port cable, I plug the adapter directly into the parallel port. At least it lights up from the get-go, but I would not receive any status codes on the display whatsoever. But wait! Somewhere I read this was supposed to be for laptop diagnostics, so let's try a laptop. I have here my Compaq Armada 5092, which serves as a guinea pig. I try wiring up the USB to the laptop itself to get the power from there, though this seems unsuccessful. Hence, I revert back to the stationary power supply. At least the car powers up, but it seems unable to detect anything because everything it shows is just the FF code. Is the card broken at last? Or would I just need to find another machine to try with? I grabbed out this IBM ThinkPad to give it a shot and see what difference it makes. We actually get to see the diagnostics codes. How awesome is that? And let's give it a try again using the parallel cable. Will it work? Oh yes, it does as well. So it took me actually several attempts to see this LPT diagnostics card in action. Whereas PCI and ISA based postcards typically just work, except on very old machines like the IBM 5150, this one here seems to be very picky about particular BIOS implementations. Furtherly, I'm not sure if this LPT based monitoring really just works just with laptops. Officially, this card is subject to be a laptop diagnostics card, so the perfect fit for my collection, which mostly consists of portable devices. However, it's well possible that only laptops emit diagnostic codes on the parallel port, as mini PCI slots might not exist or not be easily accessible, so there's a good reason for having an LPT card. I could have gone down to try with other laptops as well, but I suspect this would really just work with some mid-90s models and onwards, at least until parallel ports started to disappear in the 2000s. Still, this was a very cool piece to explore, and maybe one day it may come in handy to me. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, then please give me a thumbs up. See you next time. You're about to see some potential upcoming topics for future videos right now. Please let me know in the comments which topics you are particularly interested in. Of course, you can also drop me in some other topics you'd like me to chase down.